This Medical Minute, sponsored by Avera.
All that snow that South Dakota saw in late December shut down many parts of the state, as you know, for a couple of days in some areas.
But in cases of medical emergencies, the weather comes second to getting needed care. A story out of Pierre about how community effort helped to welcome new life in the middle of a blizzard.
In mid-December, Mary and Tanner Hilton were getting ready to welcome their second child into the world. But once the labor pain started, they encountered a slight problem.
It was pretty white out at that point, and I'd been reading all the broadcasts about how the highways were, and I wasn't really sure how we were going to get to town.
The day their new bundle of joy decided he was ready to make his grand entrance turned out to be during one of the worst blizzards Pierre had seen in decades.
We prayed for a white Christmas this year to bring a baby into the world, and it was a little more white than we had anticipated.
More than a foot's worth of snow was piling up outside their home.
I was definitely worried and concerned. I did not want to have a baby at the house.
Knowing they couldn't get out by themselves, the Hiltons reached out for help, and they just so happened to know someone who might be able to help.
He's my parents' next door neighbor.
We pay attention to what's going on. And
Craig Price, the cabinet secretary for the South Dakota Department of Public Safety, helped guide them in the right direction.
Craig Price, my parents' next door neighbor, told my parents that we should call 911. And 911 got us hooked up with the plows.
Plow drivers. With the South Dakota Department of Transportation sprung into action.
Everything else kind of took a back seat so that we can send help her way and get it plowed open so they can get to Pierre safely. These were the windows of the doors, and the snow was as high as the windows were.
Les Winsel and his crew of two others, Kyle Willis and Steve Withers, worked through blowing snow with zero visibility and 40 to 50 mile per hour winds to help get the Hiltons dug out, as Mary's labor pains were intensifying. And for Winsel, this was now personal.
Makes me feel really good. I had a kid in the blizzard of 96, so I know exactly how she feels.
Oh, you're okay.
That little tidbit Mary didn't actually know until we met with her to share her story.
How ironic is this?
That's amazing. I think every single piece of this experience was just miraculous. There wasn't anything normal. Every single step along the way felt like an obstacle, and it felt pretty surreal. So it doesn't surprise me that something as amazing is just added to this story.
Little baby Laverne is now doing well after his dramatic debut.
This was a miracle. By the grace of God, everything worked out. The team pulled together. Like, we trained for this, but for everything to go as well as it did, just a blessing. I'm always impressed and humbled with the heroes that we work with and live with in this community.
The Hiltons are now adjusting to being a family of four with plenty of gratitude in their hearts.
The plow drivers, the hospital, our community, everybody throughout our whole process.
We don't ever have enough thank yous. We are so blessed to live in the state of South Dakota and have the friendly community members that we do.
What do you think, Vern?
What a story. For more information, head over to avera.org/medicalminute.